With the global outbreak of COVID-19 and rising number of cases being identified here in India, what are the measures that we can take to A, prevent the spread of the virus, and B, to successfully treat those who are infected for a complete recovery? The first and foremost suggestion I would like to make is to educate yourselves through the right sources. In this case, it would be the WHO, the National Center for Disease Control in India, as well as the Health Ministry. I have attached a link to all of these in the description box down below. See, the thing that you have to understand is that this is a new strain of virus and we are learning as we go. So please follow the updates given by these organizations and follow the guidelines that they suggest. I know the numbers may look scary, but from what we know so far, this is a highly contagious virus but may not be as deadly. So a lot of reported cases have been of the mild variety where the person experiences symptoms of dry cough, shortness of breath and fever. When treated rightly, could make a complete recovery. The severe cases of pneumonia or respiratory failure have been noticed mostly in people over 60 years of age or those whose immunity is compromised because of an underlying risk factor like a heart disease or a pre-existing respiratory illness. But even in those cases, when they are treated rightly, they can make a full recovery. To prevent the spread of the disease, the government has already put in excellent measures to screen everyone who are traveling from the affected areas at airports as well as in the borders, and putting those who are suspected of carrying the infection in quarantine. They have also set up isolation wards in many hospitals so that infected people can be treated successfully. The two categories of people who are at greater risk of acquiring this infection are the family members of an infected person. The second group of people are healthcare providers who are treating these patients. This virus is transmitted through something called as droplet infection. So when a person who's infected coughs or sneezes, these small tiny particles of moisture or liquid is thrown out. Another person comes in contact with these, they are at a higher chances of developing this infection. So something called as social distancing, where if a person is coughing or sneezing, you maintain a distance of up to 3 meters because the droplets cannot then travel that far. Second would be if you've gone out of home and you know you're in public places, it is best to use a hand sanitizer with at least 65% of alcohol concentration in it. So keep cleaning your hands with that. But once you come home, ensure that you wash your hands properly for up to 20 seconds at least. The third thing is, if you are experiencing these symptoms, make sure that you are covering your mouth and nose when you're coughing or sneezing. Do it in a tissue paper and discard it in a closed bin, or you can even use the flex elbow to do that. Okay, masks can be hugely effective tools only for two groups of people. One, those who are infected, because wearing a mask maintains them to not spread the droplet everywhere. There is in fact a video done by WHO on how to wear and remove masks carefully. So people who are infected need to wear masks when they are out in the public or when they come in contact with others. And the second group that are in highly need of these masks and protective equipment are healthcare professionals who are treating these patients. So for normal people, there has been no evidence that wearing a mask will prevent you from acquiring an infection. If you've been traveling in the recent past and experience any of these symptoms, please call this toll-free number which has been given by the Government of India to know the centers nearest to you for testing. The government has set up many centers across India which do PCR, which is the test to confirm the virus by identifying their genetic fingerprint. There are also many hospitals in various states that have been allocated to treat with these cases successfully. The primary treatment consists of supportive care. So based on the symptoms that you are experiencing, you will be prescribed medications accordingly. There is no one single drug that kills the virus completely. Scientists are still working on that. There is also vaccination in the making, which may take up to 18 months. The best way to handle this situation is to be aware and well informed through the right channels, as well as ensuring that this information percolates through different strata of society so that everyone is aware of how to take precautionary measures, what to do when someone experiences symptoms, and where to go to get treated. So please avoid forwarding messages that are non-scientific or agenda-based on WhatsApp groups or across different social media platforms. Be alert and be safe.